you could see how merciful and generous Allah is. And from these verses, we can get a lot of comfort, especially in this difficult time. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not want to create difficulty for people. Allah does not want people to suffer. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is more merciful to us than our own mothers. Many of the non-believing and many of the people who sometimes think they know better, they ask a question and loudly they say, if your Lord is merciful, why there is suffering in the world? And this is really sad to hear that, because if we look at the world, all the suffering comes from us. And all the relief and all the ease is coming from outside. It's why when something happens like this, people say it is miraculous. Man doesn't make miracles, but Allah does. I remember when there was a hurricane in America a few years back, and a whole town or city was almost destroyed. The roofs were flown away. One house is almost flown totally away and is scattered. 3 miles away from that house, in an empty space, one roof was heard within it, a crying of a baby. When they came and lifted the roof, they found a young, newly born baby alive. People forgot everything and began to think of this miracle, because the child is fragile. If lorries were destroyed, buildings were destroyed, trees were uprooted, this is a little soft little baby. We are frightened of just even carrying them. To be flown 3 miles away and to be found totally unblemished is a miracle. So let us listen to those verses. Allah says, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم ولا تقتلوا أنفسكم. And do not destroy yourself. Do not kill yourself. إن الله كان بكم رحيما. Indeed, Allah has always been merciful towards you. Here, I would like everybody to realize that Allah is saying for 100%, whatever difficulty you find yourself in, remember, I am the one who began your initiation and continued your living through my mercy. Because without Allah's mercy, nothing exists. But he began by telling us, don't destroy yourself. Because when people reach the end of it, they want to take their life. They begin with being angry, then began to question things, then take it upon people, then hit the wall or kick something, then begin to abuse, then enter into self-isolation, then become insular, then become sad, and that leads to depression. And then the person wants to take their life. No, that's not the solution. Because the solution cannot be in finishing where you can find the solution, because the solution is within all of us. Allah then said, وَمَنْ يَفْعَلْ ذَلِكَ عُدْوَانًا وَظُلْمًا فَسَوْفَ نُصْلِيهِ نَارًا. Whosoever does this deliberately, transgressing even against their own self by taking their own life, we will surely throw them into a fire. وَكَانَ ذَلِكَ عَلَى اللَّهِ يَسِيرًا. For this, for Allah is very simple. Allah does not want to throw you in the fire to punish you, to purify you. Just like when we find the crude gold within the rocks of the ground, in order for us to take the gold, we need to put it in fire. Not any fire, extreme fire, until it becomes a liquid. And then we purify the gold and we throw the rubbish away. Because gold is gold. Gold is gold. And therefore, the spirit of human beings within these bodies is like gold. But with the nafs, and it is desires and all that it, which is accompanying it from the qareen and the shaitan and the shayateen of the human and the jinn and everything else, it becomes in need of cleansing. In tajtanibu kaba'ira ma tunhawna anhu. O children of Adam, remember, if only you avoid the big sins that we have taught you to keep away from. Nukaffir ankum sayyi'atikum. Thereafter, we will forgive you all your sins. Wanudkhilkum mudkhalan karima, and we will allow you to enter an entrance of honor. We will honor you in the day of judgment with your sins to enter honorable. Now here, nobody can do that unless there is love, and there will never be love without mercy. Because the one who claims to love will always be utmost careful never to show harshness or wickedness toward those whom he claims to love, but always to be kind, generous, lenient, compassionate, and very merciful. And therefore, Rasulullah in regard of these verses says, the one who will repent from their sins will be equal to the one who have no sins. This is so important that every time we find ourselves in difficulty, we find ourselves cornered from all directions by things that we cannot cope with, just to increase our istighfar. So I am saying this because a lot of people are suffering nowadays. And we cannot say there is no suffering. There is suffering, because even isolation brings suffering. But each one of us should think of the ni'mah that we have. The ni'mah we have is greater than anything else. We have the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Through the salawat we recite, through the example that we can read from his literature and his seerah. Also, we have more than this in front of us, the word of Allah, which we can read this every day. And in it, there will be peace. When the person begins to speak the language of Allah in reciting the Quran. And therefore Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, reflect on its verses. Don't just read it quickly and leave it. Read whatever you read every day, but every day take a verse or two or three and reflect upon them. Look for inner deeper meaning and ask Allah, oh Allah, I read what is being said. Show me, you show me. Because Allah can show you. Allah said in the Quran, وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ وَيُعَلِّمُكُمُ اللَّهِ. Do fear Allah and Allah himself will show you. Allah will teach you. Allah will direct you. The Prophet ﷺ says, three, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will laugh in their presence in the day of judgment. Yes. ثلاثة يضحك الله إليهم القيامة. Allah will laugh with them. Number one, الرجل إذا قام من الليل يصلي. When a person get up in the night just to pray. Because you are not required to get up in the night and pray. But when you do it, you are realizing the mercy with all the difficulties you are going through. So imagine somebody who's suffering, working hard, having children, having little babies to look after, having a home to clean and whatever, all these, and you are so tired, but yet you deprive yourself of your sleep to get up to turn to Allah in Salah. Allah will be so pleased with you in the day of judgment because he says, you have left your sleep and your bed for me. You're not generous. I am the most generous. وَالْقَوْمِ إِذَا صَفُّوا لِلصَّلَاةِ. And when people rush to stand in a line for salah. This shows that with all the difficulties we go through, there are people who are regularly rushing to stand in jama'ah. So whenever we can find the chance to pray together, pray together. Allah likes that. Because Allah wants to unite. Allah never wants people to disperse from one another. وَالْقَوْمِ إِذَا صَفُّوا لِلْقِتَالِ. And when people are defending themselves, when people are attacked and they're standing for qital. Listen here. The Prophet didn't say, وَالْقَوْمِ يَصْطَفُوا إِلَى الْجِهَادِ. He didn't say when people stand up for jihad. That's why the misuse of the word jihad today, it takes it out of place. Jihad literally meaning to strive. But qital is a fight. He said, when people stand to fight away the enemy, because usually when people are not concerned about themselves, they turn away. But when people want to defend their families, their homes, then that becomes, when you look at this country of ours here, when people got out in the Second World War to fight, and the soldiers were away, and the mothers and the, created their own kind of armies, and the old people created their own armies, it became something special within the, until today they talk about it, because they are standing to defend what is dear to them. And that is in the deen, mashru' were accepted. You cannot just go and fight a war, but you are allowed to do that, to defend yourself. And this is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves those people who will always stand to him. I remind myself and everybody listening, please don't despair. Please don't complain. Always when you find yourself in difficulty, remember there is somebody else who is in worse difficulty. If the home you live in, you are frightened, it's going to be repossessed because of no work, or the job you are holding, maybe you will lose, there is somebody already sleeping rough in the street. There is somebody somewhere in the world not having money even to have a drink of water. These are things that everyone who have the sense will think about, because always there will be somebody who's worse than yourself. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep me and you always aware of our condition and being grateful to the great bounties that Allah has bestowed upon us. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala remove the difficulty of everyone living upon this earth. Allahumma salli wa sallim ala Sayyidina Muhammad wa ala ali Sayyidina Muhammad wa sallim tasliman kathira. Ya man tarana wa tasma'una ya Allah. Taqabbal minna wa tab'a alina wa tawallana wa ahdina wa ahdina. Oh Allah, most merciful, most kind. Natawajjahu ilayka bi'ithmika ar-Rahman ar-Rahim al-Hayy al-Qayyum al-Aliyy al-Azim bil-Jalal wal-Ikram. We ask Allah by His most beautiful names to forgive all our sins, to erase all our ill deeds, to exchange all our bad deeds to good deeds, to multiply our good deeds to an infinite number, to allow us to die as believers, to be raised among the righteous, to dwell in the highest level of Jannah with His beloved Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, to be given the permission to drink from His blessed right hand, from Al-Kawthar, a drink that we will never be thirsty thereafter, Ya Kareem. O Allah, allow us to be among those who will have shining faces full of light, being given permission to look at you, Ya Kareem. Wujuhun yawma'idhin nadira ila rabbiha nadira. O Allah, forgive our parents and their parents to Adam alayhi salam. O Allah, all our partners in marriage, our children, our relatives, our siblings, may you forgive them. May you raise them to be pious and righteous. All those who are single, may Allah find them the best of partners. All those who are unemployed, may Allah provide for them the best of employment. All those who are working, may Allah make them honest and steadfast in doing good to earn halal, Ya Kareem. All the students who are struggling to complete their education, may Allah make it easy for them. O Allah, the world is being tested by this virus. O Allah, make it easy for all those who are struggling. O Allah, those who are sick, heal them. Those who are serving the sick, may you serve them. And those who are striving to find the solutions to get out of these troubles, may you make it easy for them, Ya Kareem. اللهم يا رب يا رحمن يا مستعان يا حي يا قيوم يا ذا الجلال والإكرام نتوجه إليك ونسألك في هذه الساعة إلا ما وفقتنا أجمعين وجعلتنا برحمتك أرحم الراحمين مع عبدك الصالحين. We ask Allah سبحانه وتعالى that He will extend through His mercy for us an extension to remain in Carlton Center for Rumi's Cave, Ya Kareem. اللهم يسر لنا البقاء فيه ويسر لنا الإمداد فيه وبارك لنا فيه بعزك وجلالك ومجدك وارتفاعك يا كريم برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. Anybody who have anything Allah is aware of, if it will benefit them, please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, may Allah fulfill it. Anybody who is in difficulty, may Allah remove it. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين. الفاتحة. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم الصراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. آمين. مصطفى السلام عليكم. الحمد لله. How are you keeping? Are you all right?
الحمد لله.
How is everything going?
It's good. الحمد لله. الحمد لله.
Ibrahim and his mother, your parents, your wife, parents, everyone is okay?
الحمد لله. الحمد لله.
الحمد لله. Maimoun, nice to see you, Maimoun. How are you?
الحمد لله. I'm good. Great to see you too.
الحمد لله. How are the twins and their mother and
They're
your
good.
Family?
They're doing good. They're still up. A little bit of a cold, but inshallah they'll be fine. Inshallah.
No, they'll be all right. They have to be difficult. They're young royals. Yeah. You have to serve them and look after them.
Inshallah.
Allah give the children this beautiful beginning so that the parents will realize that this is a gift from Allah. You need to look after them. May Allah raise them to be pious and righteous. And may Allah keep you and your wife and your children and both your families, inshallah. Akif, how are you?
Alhamdulillah, I'm very well. Thank you, Sheikh. It's wonderful to see you.
And wonderful to see you. May Allah reward you and keep you. How are the kids?
Alhamdulillah, alhamdulillah. They're having fun.
And their mother is okay?
Alhamdulillah, they're well. Thank you.
May Allah keep you all and your families, inshallah. And Daniel, mashallah, little one is sitting with you. How are you keeping? Nice to see you. Alhamdulillah. Pleasure to see you, Daniel, and your wife and all the family, inshallah. Remember us, pray for us. Give salam to Sheikh Umar.
Yes, inshallah. Sheikh. He was asking for your du'as, Sheikh, on the phone.
May Allah fulfill all his needs. Sheikh Umar is the man who's always thinking of good people. I remember maybe almost 15, 17 years ago, he used to come to the circle and he'll bring all these little bottles with what we use today to clean our hands. And he used to say to people, use this before the time, come for it. And he used to give it to people. And he used to travel to the countryside to give it to all the member of his community that he used to know. Chef, because they are not able to find them. And he used to say to me, the enemy today is these viruses. And we need to clean ourselves. He used to say, when you go in the escalators, don't hold. If you hold, use this cream to wash because somebody else is carrying. And subhanAllah, today, everybody needs to carry it in his pocket. And wherever you go, you have to clean your hand. And Jahid, how are you?
Assalamu alaikum, Sheikh Umar. Sheikh, how are you, Sheikh?
Alhamdulillah. How are you keeping in the family?
Alhamdulillah, I'm fine, Sheikh.
May Allah bless you, look after you, and grant you whatever you need, and give you tawfiq and success. And everybody else I cannot see in the screen, may Allah bless all of them and bless all of you and give you tawfiq, inshallah. We'll see you next week. Remember us and pray for us, inshallah. And pray for Rumi's cave, inshallah. Jazakumullah khair. Assalamu alaikum.